Welcome back, everyone, to Einstein's Eyes, John and I's YouTube channel. We are ophthalmologists. I'm oculoplastics. John is cornea fellowship trained. We both did our residency at Albert Einstein College of Medicine, Montefiore Medical Center. I'm in Alaska and John's in New Jersey. And we are going to talk about herpes simplex keratitis today on this YouTube video. And since this really falls in John's lane, I'm going to let John take it away.
So I'm going to let Carl know the title of this should be, I have herpes in my eye, or whatever you want to do. But I'm going to start out with a very important lesson for Carl. I don't know if he knows this, but what's the difference between herpes and love?
One keeps on giving and...
Close.
Go ahead.
Herpes is forever. So I tell all my patients that. So first of all, let's talk about herpes. So a lot of people think of herpes being genital herpes. We're not going to talk about that today, although some of you probably want to talk about it. We're going to be talking about herpes in the eye, which is actually the herpes, the type of herpes that is not genital. It's actually from the oral cavity most of the time. And what's interesting about herpes, a lot of people don't realize, is most people over the age of 18 have herpes. They have had it in their bloodstream. If you test them for titers, they'll be positive. It's not really a big deal. The issue is, why does it somehow manifest itself in some people? Some people will get canker sores in their mouth. We all know about that. Dentists know that that's basically oral herpes. And us as eye doctors, we see ocular herpes. So ocular herpes, when I see it, it's not the type of thing, again, that's genital. It's related to what was already in your bloodstream, but it's coming out. So it lives in these nerves that are near the eye, and they come out at some point, and they can either manifest themselves in the eyelid, but we're mainly going to center it on today on the cornea. So we call that herpes keratitis. Herpes keratitis is very common. It almost always is one eye. So if you had a red eye that was kind of lingering and you really didn't know what it was from, you must consider herpes keratitis.
But John, I want to say one thing. So sure. It triggers our stress.
Excellent.
Lack of sleep, too much sun, getting sick, chemo, radiation, medicines that suppress your immune system. I'll let you go.
Yeah, no, that's excellent. So what'll bring it out? So I was referring to before, herpes can be living in these nerve fibers for years. And some people, when they're just tired, or like one of the things Carl mentioned, they'll get canker sores, and they'll also get ocular herpes. Ocular herpes is much more serious because it can cause visual loss. So when I see somebody with herpes, there's a couple of different presentations. The most important thing, again, not only is herpes forever, but herpes can manifest itself in many different ways. Someone can come in with a little bit of conjunctivitis, just a little red eye. They can come with decreased vision. They can even come in with blisters around their eyelid. So there's a lot of different ways it manifests itself. And it can also mimic other conditions in the eyes. It'll look just like a corneal ulcer, like an infection. So ophthalmologists are really trained to always think of herpes before they consider other diagnoses. So when someone comes in with herpes, Carl, I think you have a good picture.
Yeah.
One of the ways. Now, this is the classic. It doesn't always show like this, but Carl's going to show this picture. So that's a great picture, Carl. I mean, this is a classic presentation. Unfortunately, we only see this maybe 5 or 15% of the time, but still, this is what's called a dendrite. If a doctor sees this, there's really no other condition. I mean, you know it's herpes.
And let me just say one thing, John. So just to give the folks a reference, this is the cornea, and this entire structure is the eye. So we're looking at the front of the eye. This is the cornea. Here's the iris, the blue or brown part. And then in the center is the pupil. And then on top of all this is this dendrite, which is the herpes infection manifesting itself with a type of stain that we put on the cornea to really highlight this and show it off.
Excellent. Yeah, so what's interesting about herpes is many years ago, kind of like the way COVID is a year or two ago, there were no treatments at all. There were no antiviral therapies. Now we have things for COVID, as we all know, But for herpes, the antivirals are amazing. They really work well. But in the old days, when there weren't antivirals, doctors were trained to what we call debride. So we would just take a concept applicator and gently rub it against this herpetic infection. And by doing that, you could actually decrease the viral load and decrease the infection. But it's not as good as what we have now. So if I see a patient like this now, I'm going to give them both topical, which means eye drops, and oral agents by mouth. So I'll give them something like valacyclovir or Zovirax, Valtrex, any of these medications. They're all really the same thing. They're pills that we're going to recommend, which kill the virus. And then while we're doing that, we also give an eye drop that's called Veroptic, which is also an antiviral eye drop that kills the virus. So usually what I'll do is I'll start out with big time antiviral therapy to try to knock out the virus quickly. I might even debride it a little bit because that helps speed it up a little bit. And then I monitor the person closely. Hopefully they come back within a few days and I can tell already that the infection is either controlled or on its way out. And that's when decision-making is tough because at that point, the body, kind of like COVID, it has this virus in their eye and we're knocking out the virus, but the body also wants to help. So the body starts to fight the infection with the immune system. So what happens is sometimes patients, even though the infection is getting better, their vision starts to get worse, their eye gets more inflamed, it gets more red, and that's when you need experience. I mean, that's when I see that, I know that it's not the infection, but it's actually the body's immune system. And what we do then is we give steroid drops. But you have to be very careful because if you give steroids too early with herpes, you can make the infection worse. So you have to time it just right. So when the infection's on its way out, you add the steroids to knock out the inflammatory response. And interestingly, this is very similar to COVID. I mean, COVID, what doctors are doing now is they're trying to knock out the virus with antivirals. And then when they see a patient still getting sicker, they add steroid therapy. So it's the same idea where a virus causes an immune response in your body. And here in the eye, it can cause scarring, which can be very serious. It can cause decreased vision. And that's where the art of medicine is, which is weighing the risk and benefit of steroid, adding it at the right time to decrease that scar formation.
That's brilliant, John.
Yeah, and then alluding to what I said at the beginning, which was a joke, but it's actually pretty serious. What I tell all my patients that have herpes in their eye is this. Even if we get rid of the infection right now with the antivirals, and even if we do a really good job of knocking out the immune system, so their cornea clears and they are left with very good vision, there's two issues. One is herpes is forever, both the infection and also the inflammatory response. So some of my patients that have had an infection will get recurrent infections. It's living in the nerve. And every once in a while, like Carl said, with certain stimuli, whether they didn't get enough sleep or they're stressed or they're getting some type of therapy, any of those things, or even a bad sunburn, the virus will come right back out and they'll be reinfected. So that's where a study that was done many years ago is very important. And what it showed was that if you leave people on a low dose antiviral pill, potentially for the rest of their life, you decrease the risk of recurrence dramatically. So that's a conversation that the doctor and the patient have to have, which is it worth staying on this therapy, potentially for years, to decrease the risk of this recurrence? And then the second part is sometimes I have patients that have such a bad immune response, meaning they're young, they're fighting this infection that's gone, that every time I back off on the steroid, they get inflammation. So I have patients that I've had for 5-6 years that are still on a steroid drop once a week or once every other day, just enough to keep the eye quiet. Because every time we stop the steroid, for some reason, their body's immune system thinks the infection's there and it riles up and it causes haze and potential scarring.
That's so brilliant.
That's herpes simplex. I mean, it's obviously a lot more complicated than I just tried to summarize, but for any patients out there, you really want to find someone with experience who really knows the art of treating you. It's a relatively easy diagnosis to make, but figuring out when to add steroids, when to back off, how quickly to slow it down, that's really the key.
Right, right. So this comes in, I might see this initially, but I would refer it to my cornea specialist. So John, hey, that was great. Thank you. I think our audience will enjoy that and find it informative. So we will see you on the next video. Please like and subscribe. We'll be right back.